Welcome to 3D printing. 3D printing opens up a world of exploration for students and educators alike. This video will cover the basics of preparing and printing your first 3D model. It is highly recommended to review the instruction guide, quick guides, and other material for complete information on using the YSoft B3D eDee print management solution. Let's get started. Hello, I am Dana, and I will walk you through the three basic steps in 3D printing with YSoft B3D eDee. 3D printing begins with a computer-generated file of a model. Whether you have created your file using CAD software or downloaded an existing file, the file needs to have the 3D layer information added. DeeControl is a desktop application where you will prepare your file and where the slicing layer is automatically added. Once the model is prepared, you'll send it to the YSoft SafeQ server. Your school probably has more than one eDee printer. With YSoft SafeQ, your print job waits for you at any eDee printer. We'll show you how that works. Finally, you prepare the 3D printer and your job is ready to print. For this demonstration, I'm going to create a math spinner. This is what it will look like. The math spinner is made up of five different files: the pipe itself, the cap, the plus symbol, the equal symbol, and the numbers. As you can see in the final math spinner, there are four different sets of numbers, but only one numbers file. We'll talk about how we will deal with this. Let's go through each of the three steps. Using DeeControl, I'll open up the 3D model files. I'll begin with the pipe itself. DeeControl is a slicing software included in YSoft B3D eDee. The YSoft website always has the latest version of the software available for Windows and Mac if using your personal device, or it should be installed on the school's computer. I can use DeeControl to open the CAD file or easily just drag and drop it into the DeeControl. You'll notice that the DeeControl displays the object relative to the size of eDee's print area, called the print bed. This way, I can see where to position the object and can make the model bigger or smaller as needed. Now, I will open up the other files by selecting Add Object button. You'll notice that the final model has two end caps, so I'll copy and paste the end cap object to duplicate it. There, now I have the two end caps I need. I also need four pieces of the object that has the numbers on it, so I will quickly create three additional copies of that object. Now, I have the nine pieces I need. It is important now to position the objects on the print bed so they don't overlap each other. I can either move the pieces by using my mouse to drag and drop, or I can use the XY coordinates. Here's a tip for you. To increase the print speed, position objects close to each other on the print bed. This minimizes unnecessary travel distance of the printhead. I will now click on Continue to get to the settings. If the print job is going to run overnight, it might not matter if the print speed is fast. Typically, the default settings do not need to be changed. I can also indicate if supports are needed. Supports are areas that will be removed after printing, but are needed to support areas of the object while it is being printed. A standard support helps to support overhanging parts, similar to how scaffolding supports a building during construction. Other supports, called initial structure, are initial layers to help stabilize the model on the print bed. I can find them in the settings. For example, a brim support adds layers around the base of the model to help it adhere to the print bed. A raft support also helps in adhering to the print bed and is useful when the model has a small initial footprint and a larger size is layered on top. It uses more material typically and therefore can take longer to print. At this point, the 3D model is ready to print. However, DeeControl is showing some useful information. It is telling me the estimated material used for this print job, and an estimate of how long the printing time will be for this print job. Looks like this will take 5 hours. I can also see each layer of the model. This is useful as you get more experienced and can make adjustments to your models. I can export the print job and its 3D layering information to my computer or removable storage, or send it to the YSoft SafeQ server to print later at any eDee printer on campus. Being able to print on any eDee printer on campus is important because someone may be using the nearest printer and will take hours to finish. I can go to any eDee printer that isn't being used and get my project printed, or find the printer that has the filament color I want to use. But we are ready to print, so I'm going to choose Send to YSoft SafeQueue server. YSoft SafeQueue is the print management software part of eDee. It sits on the school server and will hold your job for you until you arrive at the printer that you want to use. The print job won't begin until I've logged into the printer I want to use. So let's go do that. I can log in with my ID badge, or by entering a username and password, or by a combination of methods. My school can easily control who can access the printer by assigning me access rights through my ID badge or giving me login credentials. That way, I can use the printer when I need to, which may be outside of regular classroom time. I don't need to have someone print it for me. After all, that is part of the fun in using 3D printing in my schoolwork. I have several jobs that I have sent to the YSoft SafeQueue server. If I'm not sure which job it is, I can click on the details to see a large preview of my object. Also, if I was happy with any previous prints, I can easily reprint them. It depends on the settings on how long the objects will remain available for reprinting. However, if you like some objects and you know you will reprint them, YSoft SafeQueue can help you here too. Just mark the objects you want to keep as favorite, and you will have them always accessible for reprint through the favorite section. And you know what is the best about reprinting? You don't have to reprint on the very same printer. Just log in on any eDee printer and you will have your favorites available for reprinting. But now I want to print the math spinner, so I'll choose that. The doors open only after I have selected a print job and select print. I'm going to make sure that the glass is clean after the previous user and apply a light layer of glue. That is very important and ensures the first layer adheres properly. Okay, we are ready, so I'll press start printing. It's starting to print. I know it'll take a while to print, so I'll go do some studying. I've received an email notification that my print job is done, so let's go check it out. Because eDee's doors lock during printing, I know that no one can take my 3D print. It unlocks only when I log in. The model looks great and I can remove it and test it out. Be very careful when removing a model. Always remove it against a hard surface and not against your hand or fingers. There we go. Now, I can use a spatula to remove any excessive glue or filament. Clean the glass with some water and place it back ready for the next print job. In case I have printed a model with supports, I can easily break those off by hand or cut them out with some tools. I can also smoothen the surface of the object or paint it. The material itself is very resilient. With these easy three steps, we have a finished 3D model. We use DeeControl to prepare our digital file. We sent the file to YSoft SafeQueue until we were ready to print at an available printer. And finally, we prepared the printer and printed our model. That was pretty easy. Enjoy your 3D printing experience with YSoft B3D eDee.